Yeah. God for this blessed hour and opportunity where we could gather in His name and have fellowship with Him and with one another. I give my utmost respect to our special guest this morning, who is none other than Mrs. Atalia Yapto, officially the District Youth Resources Officer and District Sports Officer. Ma'am, your presence itself is an inspiration for us. We are so much glad and honored to have you in our midst. I also give my respect to our principal, academic dean, sports faculty in charge, Sir Benotto, my dear lecturers, and all the believers present here. As we have entered the holy sanctuary, let's pray and believe that we will have a blessed time together. So, without any further delay, I shall highlight the program for this morning. Nito Theological College Annual Games and Sports Meet 2022 to 2023. Opening program, 15 February, 8:30 a.m. Venue Chapel Hall. Special guest, Mrs. Atalia Yapto, District Youth Resources Officer and District Sports Officer, Zunubado. Leader, myself, Piotoli of MD3.
Shall we all look to God in prayer? Merciful Father, the creator of all the universe and sustainer of our lives, we give you glory and honor for who you are in our life. We want to thank you, O Lord, for giving us the new life along with the new day. Lord, we also want to thank you for giving your wonderful talents and gifts to all the students in this institution, where they could glorify your name in all the activities that we take up. Lord, even at this moment, as we get together in this manner to start our sports and to start again today, Lord, we invoke your presence in our midst. Lord, it is a prayer that you will continue to strengthen all students and all the faculty members and all the members of this Nito Theological College family, Lord. Without your help, without your strength, we can do nothing. And therefore, Lord, we would like to commit the day's activities into your loving hand. Lord, we also would like to invoke your presence as we get together in this manner to have our opening ceremony, Lord. It is a prayer that thou will continue to inspire each and every one of us. We also would like to commit the life of our guest speaker. We want to thank you for bringing her in our midst. May you continue to inspire her, strengthen her, give her your wisdom, give her your strength, so that, Lord, she can be a source of inspiration to all the students and to all the community members of this institution. We would like to commit our life and this entire program into your loving hand. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen. The scripture reading, which is taken up from the book of the letter of James, chapter 1, something following. Every generous act of giving with every perfect gift is from above, coming down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variation or shadow due to change. In fulfillment of his own purpose, he gave us birth by the words of truth, so that we will become a kind of fruit of his creatures. This is the word of God.
A very good morning to all of you.
Good morning.
I want to thank our Lord Almighty for enabling us to begin the Nito Theological College Annual Sports Meet 2022 to 2023. To grace this occasion, we were praying and looking forward, and the Lord has blessed us a right person in our midst this morning. And therefore, I take this time to express our gratitude and welcome to our respected special guest, Madam Atalia Yapto, the District Youth Resources and Sports Officer. It is my pleasure to welcome you, ma'am. Thank you for accepting our request and gracing us with your presence. And we believe that your presence is going to make a great impact in our community. And therefore, I would like to once again extend a very welcome to you. May I request you to kindly stand and show your face to our community. Shall we welcome her? Thank you so much. As she comes up to the stage and addresses to us, we will all open our hearts and minds and receive the blessing. We believe that human mind should be nurtured through various aspects, and therefore, sports is a part of our annual event, where the community come together to exhibit the talents, have fun, and also give space for our physical and emotional development, along with the academic pressures that we tackle with. And therefore, I also want to once again welcome all the community members as we begin this annual sports meet for 2022 and 2023. I once again welcome all of you, and I encourage all the community members to take this time as an opportunity. Please have fun, relax, and enjoy. Once again, welcome all of you to this annual event. God bless NTC.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Caught in a landslide, no escape from reality. Open your eyes, look up to the skies and see.
Oh,
good.
All the time.
And all the time,
God is good.
Giving all glory and honor to our Almighty God for blessing us this wonderful time. Respected our special guest and her colleagues, our principal, faculties and staff, not forgetting our student community. I, on behalf of our principal, faculties, staff, and the student community, not forgetting our sports committee, we would like to thank our special guest, Madam Atoli Yepto, the district youth resources officer and the district sports officer. Maybe we want to say thank you so much for, we know that at this kind of situation as a government servant, you have been so busy, but we want to thank you for accepting our request, and we also want to thank you for availing your time to grace our this annual games and sports 2022 and the year 2023, for the year 2022-2023. Now as you come here to grace our this occasion, we just want to give a certificate as a token of our love and appreciation. Maybe we can stand and receive.
And so many local Nora Fatili, Shakira and Jennifer Lopez amongst you. It's been exactly over 10 years, a little over 10 years since I last had this kind of annual meet. Not as a guest, but as one of athletes like you all. I was a bit reluctant and confused as what to say to about sports to my fellow theologians, being a theological college. But on deeper thought, I realized that sports is an integral part of education. We cannot do away with sports. It is a part of the curriculum. And to know the advancement and progress of a society is through sports. So realizing those things, I gratefully accepted to be a part of the program. All work and no play makes Jack a dull boy. Now, of course, I know it's a cliche, but all cliches do have some truth in it. The truth being very simple, that if you are not active, if you are not into sports, the work that you are doing, the intellectual pursuit that you are here in the campus, the studies that you are doing, like Mimi said, the pressure of studying, it gets burned out somewhere in some situation. So when we are physically fit, we know we have the extra edge to face any mental challenges and our intellectual in our intellectual pursuit too. sports, like I said, sports is not all about competition. If you want to know the character of a person, it is through sports, as how he humbly accepted the failure or how he reacts to winning. So like a person who has a true spirit of sportsmanship can build can face the twists and turns of life more gracefully and more calmly in a composed manner. Having said that, I've come across many churches and communities. You know, in our society, the church is the only platform where we socially connect with each other, right? So like, I've come across many communities and many churches using sports as a medium to evangelize the youth, to bring the youth to make a change, to make a difference for Christ. Like for example, you all must have come across Mr. Colomero. He is presently the president of Nagaland Football Association. And I'm sure he is also one, like a theologian like all of you. Because while we were in college, I was not in the college where he was the chaplain, but he was the chaplain of Jaffa Christian College. And he is the biggest football fan in Nagaland, I think. And he has this life ministry, life sports ministry, which through this ministry, he brings a lot of football fans together, and they even have a social media handles like Nagaland Manchester United and all. So sometimes when I scroll, I used to follow, stalk them. So that's where he gathers most of the football fans, and maybe through this sports, he maybe the objective is to bring them closer to God. So like, he is using the sports to evangelize the youth, like you and me. So it is my belief that as you go out from this campus, you're all going to be the leaders of the churches and all. So I'm sure you'll be using the sports creatively, like our circle around the way he used sports to bring many youth together. Huh? So it is my belief that you will also do the same. And bring changes in our society, maybe through sports, or maybe it depends on how creatively you use the sports as a medium. It also, you know, sports also, I'll just continue, maybe yes. I have a very big voice. It also enhances our leadership skill, it boosts our confidence. So I hope you use sports as a medium to bring changes in the society. Lastly, as many say, sports is not all about competition, it's all about winning or losing. So you're all winners at the end of the day. So it's my request that you will loosen up a little, enjoy yourself, cherish the moment, make memories, you're all winners. Coming to the conclusion, I wish that you will enjoy the rest of the event. Thank you so much for having me.
Rules, which has been set for, as the competitors of this game, I hereby swear and agree to play the games in the highest forms and standard of discipline and sportsmanship.
I, Ms. Atomi Yatok, District Youth Resource and Sports Officer, to hereby declare the MCC Annual Sports Week 2023 open.
Shall we all be in one mind as we pray? Merciful God, gracious loving Heavenly Father, we come before you with great reverence and in awe for your matchless grace upon each and every one of us. Thank you so much, Lord Jesus, for helping us in all the things, and thus far you have led us, and we want to acknowledge your mighty hand upon us, upon our community. Thank you so much, Lord Jesus, for giving us this another day. Thank you so much for helping us to witness your love, your care, even this morning. Lord, we have been praying for this day, and as you have helped each and every one of us to step into the first session of this program, we want to thank you. We acknowledge your grace upon each and every one of us this morning, Lord Jesus. We also want to thank you for the life of all the programmers, Lord Jesus, who have put their efforts in making this first session a grand success. Thank you so much for the skills. Thank you so much for the talents that they possess. Oh Lord Jesus, whatever they have exhibited this morning, they have did all for your glory, and we want to thank you for their life. It is our prayer that you will continue to use each and every one of them so that through their Lord Jesus, through the talents, through the gift, and through the things that you have placed upon them, they will continue to shine for your glory. We want to thank you so much, Lord Jesus, for our resource person this morning. Thank you so much, Lord Jesus, for inspiring us through her life. It is our prayer that you will strengthen her, you will motivate her, you will encourage her at all times so that she will stand for right and she will stand for your glory, Lord Jesus. Thank you so much for being in our midst, and as we disperse from this place and resume with our activity, it is our prayer that may your continuous guidance and protection be upon each and every one of us, protect our community from all the danger and harm, and help each and every one of us so that we could create a memory and give you glory in return. May you disperse each and every one of us with your blessing. In Jesus' name, with thanksgiving, we offer this prayer.
Amen.